Projects are initiated when someone with enough authority within the organization decides to mobilize resources for the project. To make such a decision, the organization must have concluded that the project is favorable and better than other available options. Sometimes this decision is based on an empirical analysis of the project. Other times, the organization adopts structured methods to identify, select, and prioritize projects. There are several types of project selection methods. Each method has a different perspective on project feasibility. To prepare for the exam, we will analyze the most relevant financial and economic methods, including the net present value, the internal rate of return, the payback period, the benefit-cost ratio, and the opportunity cost. The logic behind these methods is that the value of the project to the organization may be quantified financially. This financial evaluation allows the organization to make a structured decision regarding whether to accept or reject a potential project, or choose among alternative projects. The net present value, NPV, is the present value of the project future cash flows. To better understand this concept, let's clarify the meaning of present value and cash flows. The concept of present value is based on the economic theory of the time value of money. This theory recognizes that money held today is not the same as money held tomorrow. If you send money to the future, by, for example, depositing money in the bank, you should receive a greater value. As an example, if you deposit $1,000 in the bank today and hold the deposit for a year, with an interest rate of 10%, you will receive your deposit of $1,000 back, plus the interest. If you decide to keep the money in the bank after the first year, it will continue to generate interest according to the interest rate. The future value of today's deposit can be calculated by applying the following generic capitalization formula. When we are determining if the project is worthwhile pursuing, we are not really questioning about the future value of today's money. Our question should be, if the expectations of future money generated by the project more than compensate the money that has to be mobilized by the project today plus the interests. The present value of expected project return can be calculated by applying the following generic discounting formula. Cash flow represents money flowing in and out of the project, and are the second pillar of the net present value method. When you deciding whether to press project start button, you need to take into account money inflows, such as an expected increase in revenue and cost savings, as well as cash outflows, such as required investment and expected cost increases. For example, the cash flow of a project established to redesign the store's layout of a major retailer can be determined by the initial investment on equipment, the expected increase on revenue, and by the expected increase in shop maintenance costs. The net present value is used to compare cash flows generated in different periods. Expected future cash flows are discounted to the present period, considering the cost of time. This cost of time is represented by a discount rate. The discount rate will vary from one organization to the other, depending on factors such as rate of return of previous projects and interest rate of bank loans. Once calculated, the NPV supports a rapid interpretation of the project return. If the net present value is greater than zero, the project is favorable, adding value to the organization. If the net present value is less than zero, the project is unfavorable. You do not need to know how to calculate the net present value. You just need to understand the concept. However, if you are curious about the subject, the net present value formula is shown on screen, where I stands for discount rate and N for number of years. Here are two examples. Both projects have the same amount of investment, $36,000, and the same return, $45,000. However, in the first example, most of the return is generated in the first 2 years, while in the second, most of the return is generated in the two last. This difference will have a strong impact on present values once a discount rate is applied. The first example has a positive net present value, while the second has a negative. Payback period is the period of time required for the project to repay the original investment. To calculate the payback period, first, estimate the future cash flows generated by the project. Then, calculate the accumulated cash flow for each year. Finally, count the number of periods necessary for the cumulative cash flow to reach zero. If the payback period is less than a specified limit, the initiative is acceptable. On this example, the initial investment is repaid during the third year. Internal rate of return assesses the return of the project by calculating which discount rate would make the net present value equal zero. If the internal rate of return is greater than the discount rate, the initiative adds value. You do not need to know how to calculate the IRR. You just need to understand the concept. However, if you are curious about the subject, the NPV formula is shown on screen. In this chart, you can watch how a net present value would drop if the discount rate were to increase. Notice that the rate where the net present value at zero is the internal rate of return. A benefit-cost ratio is the ratio of the benefits of a project relative to its costs. Benefits and costs should be expressed in discounted present values. A benefit-cost ratio of 1.2 means that the benefits are 1.2 higher than the cost. If a benefit-cost ratio equals 1, it is a break-even project. If a benefit-cost ratio is less than 1, the project is not financially attractive. If a benefit-cost ratio is higher than 1, the project adds value. The opportunity cost is the cost of losing the best available alternative to the project. This economic project selection methods assumes that choices are mutually exclusive and resources are constrained. As an example, an organization may have as alternative potential initiatives projects A, B, and C. All of them have positive net present values. From the financial point of view, the three projects are financially attractive. However, projects A and B are not a good economic decision because their best available alternative, or opportunity cost, is actually higher than their return. This video was developed by XPM Consulting. XPM is a project management, agile, IT and leadership training company. Thank you for watching. We hope you found the video interesting, and if you did, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel.